Instructing Monks in the Monastery Hall. After the Buddha attained enlightenment, he embarked on a mission to share his insights with anyone who was willing to listen. He traveled throughout India, walking from village to village, town to town, and city to city, teaching his philosophy and ethics to the people. The Buddha's teachings resonated deeply with many individuals, who found solace and peace in his words. As he traveled, he accumulated a large following of devotees who were eager to learn from him and live according to his teachings. Among his followers were monks who wished to devote their lives to the practice of Buddhism. They were drawn to the Buddha's teachings, which offered a path to inner peace and enlightenment, and they sought his guidance and instruction. The Buddha recognized the value of having a dedicated space where his followers could come together and learn from him in a structured environment. He encouraged the building of monasteries, where the monks could live, study, and practice together. One of the most important areas of the monastery was the hall where the Buddha would teach. It was here that the monks would gather to listen to the Buddha's teachings, engage in spiritual practice, and ask questions. As the Buddha taught in the monastery hall, he noticed that some of the monks were struggling to stay focused and attentive. Despite their best efforts, they would become drowsy or distracted during his teachings, hindering their progress on the path to enlightenment. The Buddha recognized that he needed to find a way to help his monks stay alert and engaged during his teachings. He knew that mindfulness was an essential part of the Buddhist path, and he believed that by teaching his monks to be more mindful, they could overcome their distractions and improve their concentration. To help his monks develop mindfulness, the Buddha introduced a new technique called mindfulness of breathing. He explained to the monks that by focusing their attention on the sensation of the breath as it flowed in and out of their bodies, they could learn to develop greater concentration and awareness. He instructed them to sit in a comfortable position, close their eyes, and focus their attention on the breath. As they breathed in, they would notice the sensation of the air filling their lungs, and as they breathed out, they would notice the sensation of the air leaving their body. Over time, the monks who practiced mindfulness of breathing began to experience profound changes in their mental states. They found that they were able to concentrate more deeply, experience greater peace and tranquility, and develop a more profound understanding of the nature of reality. The Buddha's teachings on mindfulness of breathing continue to be an important part of Buddhist practice today. The practice of mindfulness has been shown to have many benefits, including reducing stress and anxiety, improving concentration and focus, and increasing feelings of calm and well-being. The story of the Buddha teaching mindfulness of breathing in the monastery hall reminds us of the importance of cultivating awareness and presence in our daily lives. By learning to pay attention to the present moment and develop greater awareness of our thoughts, emotions, and sensations, we can develop a greater sense of inner peace and well-being, and deepen our understanding of the nature of reality. The story also highlights the importance of adapting teaching methods to suit the needs of students, demonstrating the Buddha's compassion and dedication to helping his followers achieve enlightenment.